Well, I reckon you didn't do it then.
Why do you say that?
You know, I've driven a bunch of fellas down to this prison. Lord knows how many. Usually it's about now I get the, I didn't do it.
Every time?
Every time.
We got what looks like a 1091E near P3X-385. All cars asked to keep on the lookout for 91.
I followed your case a little bit. You being a Macon boy and all.
You're from Macon, then?
Yep. Came up to Atlanta to be a city cop in the 70s. Always wanted to work a murder case. Like that senatorial mess you got yourself mixed up in. With all due respect. A real shame, that is. Hell, the whole family used to be regulars at your folks' drugstore right in downtown. Still there?
Sure is.
Good.
Any of that seem important to you?
All of it, but that box never shuts up. Sit in this seat and pay too much attention and you'll drive yourself crazy. I got a nephew up at UGA. You teach there long?
Going on my 6th year.
You meet your wife in Athens? You want to know how I see it?
Sure.
Regardless, could be you just married the wrong woman. You'll have to learn to stop worrying about things you can't control. I'm driving this man once. He was the worst one. He wouldn't stop going on about how he didn't do it. He was an older fella, big soft eyes behind a pair of smart folk glasses. And he just wailing back there. Says it wasn't him. Crying and snotting all over right where you're sitting.
All officers are available for incoming T1.
Then before long, he starts kicking the back of the seat like a fussy baby on an airplane. And I tell him he's got to stop. But that's government property. And I'll be forced to zap him otherwise. So he stops, and having exhausted all his options, he starts crying out for his mama. Mama, it's all a big mistake. It wasn't me.
So did he do it?
They caught the fucker red-handed, stabbing his wife, cutting her up as the boys came through the door. He sits in my car screaming bloody murder that it wasn't him. I think he actually believed it himself. It goes to show, people will up and go mad when they believe their life is over. I got another good one for you. This one's a little bit less depressing and a bit more hilarious if I do say
so.
Watch
out!
This other time...
Officer, are you all right? I'm still cuffed back here.
Damn it! I need to drag myself out that window. Officer? Officer. Holy shit! Get away from me! Where the hell are you? Don't make me do this! Hello? Anybody? Anybody up there?
I'd fill one of those teacups with some bourbon if I could. Ladder. I'm not getting up there anyway. This leg, the way it is. I'll just go for a dip.
Hello? Anybody home? I need a little help.
Hello? There's something going on. Coming in. Don't shoot, okay? Not an intruder. Or one of them. These people might need more help than I do. This place has been ransacked. Just about anything worthwhile is gone. What's that beeping? That's a Savannah area code, but that's the type of note you'd leave a babysitter.
Ed had a little incident with some crazy guy near the hotel, so we had to get him back to the ER and have it checked out. Anyway, he's not feeling well enough to drive back tonight, so we're staying an extra day. Thanks so much for looking after Clementine, and I promise we'll be back in time before your spring break.
Message 2. Left at 11:19 p.m.
Oh my God, finally. I don't know if you tried to reach us. All the calls are getting dropped. They're not letting us leave and aren't telling us anything about Atlanta. Please, please, just leave the city and take Clementine with you back to Murrieta. I've got to get back to the hospital. Please let me know that you're safe.
Message 3. Left at 6:51 a.m.
Clementine, baby. If you can hear this, call the police. That's 911. We love you. We love you. We love you.
Daddy?
Huh? Hello?
You need to be quiet.
Are you okay?
I'm okay. They tried to get me, but I'm hiding until my parents come home.
What's your name?
I'm Clementine. This is my house.
Hi, Clementine. I'm Lee. Where are your parents?
They took a trip and left me with Sandra. They're in Savannah, I think. Where the boats are?
Where are you?
I'm outside in my treehouse. They can't get in.
That's smart.
See? Can you see me? I can see you through the window.
Man. Hi there.
Did you kill it?
I think something else did. Before me, I think.
I heard her scream 2 nights ago. Maybe one of the monsters got her.
2 nights ago? Yeah, that's probably what happened. You've been all by yourself through this?
Yeah, I want my parents to come home now.
I think that might be a little while, you know?
Oh.
Look, I don't know what happened. But I'll look after you until then.
What should we do now?
We need to find help before it gets dark.
Yeah, it's not safe at night.
Let's go. Stay close to me.
I ain't never getting home to Mama at this rate.
This sucks.
Oh, it's hot dish night.
What's the matter?
Should I stay?
What?
I don't want to sleep in the treehouse tonight, but I don't know if I should leave. What if my parents come home?
I won't leave you alone.
Let's go somewhere safe that's close, okay?
That's a good idea.
Hey, man!
Holy shit!
Don't eat us! We're not gonna hurt you.
Yeah. Thought for a second you and the little one were both gonna give us the chomp.
What are you doing?
Trying to get home. This neighborhood's a disaster. Are you trying to get out of here? Because you should be. Those things are all over the damn place. I haven't seen anything as gnarly as this neighborhood since downtown Atlanta, 15 miles back. I'm Sean. Sean Green.
Lee, this is Clementine.
I'm Chet.
We shouldn't be out in the open like this. How about you help us clear the way, and we'll take you and your daughter out of here and down to my family's farm. It should be safer there.
I'm not a dad. Her babysitter. Her parents are out of town.
Let's get going. Staying put for too long is a mistake.
What do you want to do?
The monster's come out.
We gotta go.
Lee, quick. Let's go. Babysitters go? I'd say your parents owe you a tip.
Sean, I'm gonna run on home. My mama's gonna be in a snit.
No sweat, man. I'll catch you tomorrow night.
It was nice to meet you both.
Thank God you're okay.
I was worried it'd be bad here, too.
Been quiet as usual the past couple days. Old Brecken down the way thinks his mare's gone lame, but that ain't nothing new.
I wouldn't have made it back without Chet.
Well, I'm glad you took him with you then. You've brought a couple guests.
Your boy's a lifesaver.
Glad he could be a help to somebody. So it's just you and your daughter then?
Oh, not his daughter. He's the babysitter.
Honey, do you know this man?
Yes.
Okay then. Well, looks like you hurt your leg pretty bad there.
Yeah, it's not doing so good.
I can help you out. Sean, run on in and check on your sister. You, take a seat up on the porch and I'll go see what I have. Let's have a look. Yeah, this is swollen to hell.
It hurts like hell.
I bet it does. What did you say your name was?
It's Lee.
Nice to meet you, Lee. I'm Herschel Green. How'd this happen?
Car accident.
That's so. Where are you headed before the car accident?
I was getting out of Atlanta.
The news says stay.
Yeah, well, that's a mistake. We hit a guy. One of those things you've been hearing about. On the road.
Who are you with, the girl?
I was with a police officer. He was giving me a ride.
Awful nice of him.
I'm an awful nice guy.
House is full up with mine. We got another displaced family of three sleeping in the barn. You and your daughter are welcome to rest there when we're done here. I didn't catch your name, darling.
Clementine.
Can't imagine what you've been through, Clementine.
Looking after her until we find her parents.
Hey, Dad. So I'm thinking, first thing tomorrow, we gotta reinforce the fence around the farm.
That doesn't seem necessary.
I don't know what you saw on TV or heard on the radio, but there's some serious shit hitting the fan. I don't think anyone knows how big it is yet.
I wouldn't worry too much. We're pretty far from the city. Seems like that's where it's the worst.
Yeah. Stuff like that doesn't happen around here, Sean.
Dad, I'm serious. Lee, come on. Tell him what you saw out there, man.
I got chased by a couple of dead people.
Well, do what you think you should. We got plenty of chores as it is.
Lee and those folks in the barn can help out in the morning. We gotta do it. Really.
I already said okay. Well, I'm all done here. It should start to feel better tomorrow.
Thanks.
But if your leg gets hot or the swelling doesn't go down, you're probably dealing with an infection.
What do we do then?
We'll probably just have to shoot you. We'll clean it, redress it, and you'll be fine.
Okay, that'd be preferable.
There's blankets and such in the barn. We'll be seeing you bright and early. Come tomorrow, which way you think you're headed?
Towards Macon, I suppose. All right, then.
It smells like...
manure.
Manure? Like when a horse plops?
Just like that.
I missed my mom and dad.
I bet, Clem.
How far is Savannah?
Pretty far.
Oh, okay.
I love you, baby. Hey!
Hey, get up.
I'm itchy.
Well, you slept in a barn, little lady. Lucky you don't have spiders in your hair. But I bet your daddy scared them all away, huh?
I'm not her dad. Name's Lee.
I'm Kenny.
Dad, we're in the middle of a fence! There's a tractor and everything!
We better get going, or we won't hear the end of it. That's my boy, Ken Jr. We call him Duck, though.
Duck?
Yeah, nothing bothers him. Like water off a duck's back, you know?
That's a valuable trait lately.
No kidding. But frankly, I think it's because he's dumb as a bag of hammers.
Dad!
But he makes up for it with enthusiasm. The word is, you were on your way to Macon.
My family's from there.
Well, Macon's on the way, and personally, I'd appreciate the company of a guy who can knock a couple of heads together if he has to.
I'll see what the girl would like.
Ah, gotta consult the missus. I understand. Honey, Duck, this is Lee. And what's the girl's name?
Clementine.
Clementine.
That is a very pretty name.
Thanks.
Well, we should get to work. We've all seen what those things can do out there, so the faster we get this fence up, the better.
I want to build a fence.
Yeah? Well, I need a good foreman. You can sit on the tractor and yell at me whenever I take a water break.
On the tractor? Cool!
Duck and I will hop to it.
I can keep an eye on your little girl here on the porch. We can visit.
Hey there, girls. So, what do you do when corpses aren't walking around?
I'm a veterinarian back in Fort Lauderdale, like Herschel here, except more with dogs and cats and not horses. What is it that you do, Lee?
I used to teach up at the University of Georgia.
We need to hope that we can go back to our jobs soon, Lee. Back to normal. It can't stay like this.
Yeah, my mistake.
We'll all be home soon.
How did you handle getting through the city?
Kenny just drove. We passed so many people that needed help, and we just passed people over some.
It's okay. It's fine. You don't have to say anymore.
I want to go home tomorrow, but even then I can't take away the things we...
the things Doc went through. Don't you want to go back to the moment before you knew about all of this?
This could all be providence, you know?
Not what we saw.
You just never realize when something is happening to you, what you're being given. Maybe this will all work out.
Your optimism is refreshing. New. These past couple days, at least.
You two actually look relaxed.
I think we're doing just fine. Clementine was just telling me about first grade.
Oh, how's that?
It's easy.
Well, yeah. So, you're good?
Anyway, it's almost like we didn't see people eating each other for the past 3 days. It's peaceful here, no?
Back in a bit.
Okay, Lee.
Hey there, Kenny. So what's your family's plan?
Get back on down to Lauderdale and let this mess get sorted out. Government will start handing out shots and the National Guard will do its thing. On the odd chance things got too bad, we could hop on my boat, I guess.
You've got a boat?
I'm a commercial fisherman, catching mackerel, dolphin, whatever's biting and paying. Katya wouldn't be wild about it, but the boat's not that bad.
How's your son doing?
Good, I think. Katya's got a sister up in Memphis. We were coming back from visiting her. We were in a gas station and some guy grabbed my boy. I thought he was kidnapping him. I was on the fucker in about 2 seconds and... Christ. Just lucky I was there. We saw a lot of bodies before we stumbled upon Herschel's. But we're a tough family, Lee. Ain't nothing gonna faze us.
Need any help?
No, I think I got it. Do you need any help?
What do you mean?
Well, I mean in taking care of that little girl. You know what you're doing? You got kids of your own?
I have no idea what I'm doing.
At least you're honest. Shit, better than I was when Duck showed up. You'll figure it out.
See you.
Hey, Lee.
Need a hand?
That'd be great. If you could cut those 2x to length, that sure speed things up. My dad doesn't know how bad it is.
No, he doesn't.
I saw a guy in Atlanta kill a kid. A boy. Just shot him right in the face.
Was the boy one of the walkers?
I don't even know. He was either attacking the guy or asking for help. He didn't even hesitate. He just turned, put the barrel of the gun right between the kid's eyes, and pulled the trigger. You don't see things like that. It's not like in the movies.
They don't fall like you think.
Did you have to do it?
Do what?
Kill. Have you had to off one yet?
Oh. Sometimes, it's kill or be killed.
I guess. I don't think I'd sleep good after that. I'm just glad we're getting this fence built. Dad just wants to keep the family safe and thinks inviting people in is a bigger threat than whatever's out there. How about yours? How's your family?
Not too close with my family.
Oh. Well, they weren't in Atlanta, right? So that's good. That's probably all I need cut for now. Thanks.
And Sean, thanks again for the ride.
No problem, Lee. Couldn't leave you behind. Anyway, when you see my dad around, he might want some help in the barn.
How'd you get out of Atlanta?
I got a ride and then I was in a wreck. I walked until your boy found me.
Well, you're no worse for wear.
This farm's a nice plot of land.
Had you told me 20 years ago I'd still be doing this, I would have told you that you were full of crap. Never was a plan, having a place like this. It was in the family, and I guess so was I. Family's important. It's all that matters. You agree with that?
Was brought up to, yes.
Where's your family now? Parents? Wife? Girlfriend?
My parents are in Macon with my brother.
Well, I hope they're all right. But now you've got this little girl to take care of. Clementine, is it? You just stumbled up on her?
Yeah, I was looking for help in her house.
Can I give you a piece of advice?
Sure.
I don't know who you are or what you did. Let's say things don't get better back in the cities, or they get worse before they do. You're going to have to depend on the honesty of strangers if you're going to make it. And if those same people get to questioning yours, you're going to be in trouble. But at least you have the common sense to listen to a man giving you advice.
Go! I'll get my gun!
I'm okay, Pop. I'm okay.
I can fix you, don't worry. We'll stitch you up.
It almost got me, man. They tried to save me.
I know, son.
Get the fuck out of here!
I'm sorry.
Sorry?
Your son is alive.
You don't get to be sorry!
You tried to help him, but this piece of shit let him die.
If Kenny had helped, his son would be alive.
And that's why I'll wish you were dead for the rest of my life.
Please. Just go.
Get out and never come back.
You've got that ride to Macon if you want it.
Well,
This is as far as we're going.
Then it's far enough.
Hey there! You friendly? Truck's run out of gas. Fuck!
We're trapped! Run!
We can't take risks like this. And we can't just let people die, either. When I say that door stays shut no matter what, I fucking mean it. We don't know who these people are. They could be dangerous.
Worse, they could have led them right to us.
Where the hell is your humanity?
We're not dangerous. Just regular folks.
What's dangerous is a bunch of people running outside and drawing their attention to us.
Lee's right. We're just regular folks, but we actually like helping people.
You'll have to excuse her.
The hell he, or anyone will. This is about survival. Do you guys not see what's happening?
What is it?
I have to pee.
I'd go out there again in a second.
I bet you would.
They've got kids, Lily.
Those things outside don't care.
Maybe you should go join them then. You'll have something in common.
God damn it, Lily. You have to control these people.
Carly and Glenn just ran out there.
She's the leader here, but it looks like she's losing control of her people.
If you were in my shoes, you'd be the...
Holy shit.
Son of a bitch. One of them is bitten.
Shit.
We let one in, you stupid shits.
We have to end this now.
Over my dead body, we'll dig one hole.
No! I'm cleaning him up! There's no bite! He's fine!
Don't you fucking people get it? We've already seen this happen! We let someone with a bite stay in, and we all end up bitten!
Shut up! We gotta throw him out! Or smash his head in!
Kenny! Stop him!
Hey, what do we do about this guy?
Dad, it's just a boy. It's...
Lily, I'll handle this.
But your heart, Dad. You need to calm down. We'll get this kid out of here.
With or without you? Protecting my kid with my life.
Everyone, chill the fuck out! Nobody is doing anything.
Shut up, Lily. And you, shut the fuck up. They will find us, and they will get in here, and none of this will fucking matter. But right now, we're about to be trapped in here with one of those things.
What the hell are you talking about?
He's bitten! That's how you turn!
He's not bitten. Lee, stop this. It's upsetting him.
Oh, I'm upsetting him. Upsetting is getting eaten alive.
Dad, we get it. It's a big deal.
It's Larry, right? Man, this is his son.
Look around, dumbass. I got a daughter in here. You got a daughter in here. Get your head out of your ass, boy.
We've all got people in here. We can figure this out without killing anybody. There's another way.
Yeah, with a shovel.
I'm gonna kill him, Cat. Just worry about Duck.
Lee!
Yeah?
There's someone in there!
It's just locked. Key's behind the counter. Probably.
Hey, I'm not the bad guy here. I'm just looking out for my daughter.
No, you're just the guy arguing for killing a kid.
He's covered in muck. She'll find the bite. Watch!
She won't.
And if she does, the first thing he'll do is sink his teeth into his mom's face.
Then, when she's dead, he'll probably pounce on your little girl.
Then we do what you say. We toss him out and save the group.
Lee? What the fuck, man?
What other choice is there?
Finally! Someone gets some sense. But we can't wait. We are tossing him out now.
I'm sorry, Kenny. He's right. This is about survival.
Lee? This is my boy, Lee! My boy! We can't!
No, he's not bitten. Look, he's clean. Not a scratch.
Not a goddamn scratch. What do you think about that?
It's Larry, and I'm fucking sorry.
Good.
Look, we're fish in a barrel here. With all the commotion, we could be under siege any minute.
And we better start fortifying this place. I'll work on getting that window barricaded.
Good. Dad, sit down.
I'm fine, Lily.
Dad, please.
All right.
Jesus! Get away from her, you son of a bitch!
You okay?
Just great, thanks.
Guys?
Everybody down! Stay quiet!
They're gonna get in!
Shut up!
Is that the military?
I don't know.
Thank God for whatever it is.
We almost died because of this bitch and Richie Triggerfinger. That was stupid. That was...
Dad!
What's wrong with it?
It's his heart.
My pills.
Nitroglycerin pills?
Yes, we're out. We've been trying to get into the pharmacy since we got here. Please try to get in there. Behind the counter where the pills are.
There's probably another entrance. Maybe through the office.
How do you know that's an office?
Educated guess.
It doesn't matter. We need nitroglycerin pills. Please get in there. I'll keep an eye on my dad.
Everyone else should get comfy and look for anything useful. We could be in here a while.
I'm starting to think this drugstore isn't a permanent solution.
You're right. This ain't exactly Fort Knox.
What do you suggest?
We need as much gas as possible so we can all get out of downtown Macon. Fast.
Agreed.
And I'll head out and get gas. There's a motel not too far from here, out towards the end of Peachtree. I'll work my way towards it and then loop back, siphoning what I can.
Damn, that'd be great.
Well, it's gotta get done. Plus, I'm quick, and I know Macon.
Local?
Born and raised.
If you're gonna do that, here's a walkie-talkie if you get in a tight spot. Hopefully. You won't need it.
Cool.
Clementine's got the other one. Check in with her and get back here as soon as you can.
And you? What's your name?
It's Lily. My dad's Larry.
Keep a good eye on him. These boys will work on getting you your medicine.
That's right.
And you? You keep an eye on that front door. You're our lookout.
It's Doug. You got it.
And I'm Carly.
Okay, Carly. You'll shift in with Doug when he needs it. For now, get some rest. You're a good shot, and I'd like to keep it that way.
You got it, boss.
Now get him those pills.
Not much, but here you go.
Thank you.
Of course. It's not much, but here.
You sure?
Yeah. You're under quite a bit of stress.
Thanks. That's, really sweet.
Don't mention it.
We can't let anything happen to Ducky.
I know, hon.
What are you messing around with there?
A radio. I can't get it to work, though.
Here, let me have a look. There are no batteries in this thing.
What now?
You know that there are no batteries in that thing.
Yeah, of course. I mean, yeah. No.
I can try to find some. Needs two.
Thanks. I wouldn't even really know what to look for.
Here. I've been finding some stuff to eat.
Oh, thanks.
You're welcome.
Are you sure your girl doesn't eat it?
She's good. I've been trying to keep her fed and watered.
You're a good caretaker.
Thanks.
Was he sick?
Nah, he was okay. I actually saw him whoop shoplifters with it. This cane's protected this place better than any guard dog ever could. Plus, he knew how to make it look cool. Like you with your hat.
My dad gave it to me.
See, dads are smart like that. Better get this door clear, huh?
Can I help?
Sure. Here we go. Watch your fingers in the drawers. Things have been scary, huh?
Yeah. It's not good. I don't know why everyone is crazy.
Neither do I, Clementine. Nobody does, I don't think.
I bet my dad does.
Okay, here we go.
Do you have kids?
No.
You don't have a family?
What do your parents do?
My mom is a doctor, and my dad is an engineer.
Those are good jobs.
What's your job?
I teach history and writing and things like that.
Like social studies?
Yeah, like that.
You didn't answer my question.
All right, a little further.
Why don't you want to talk about your family? Do they, like, hate you?
Because they're dead.
Oh, I'm sorry.
You didn't know.
I'm just sorry for being mean.
Look, my family's gone and I just wish things would have been different.
Yeah.
I got into some trouble and I didn't talk to him for a while. This used to be their store. But let's just keep that between you and me, okay?
Okay. Because of the trouble?
Yeah, that's right. Now, let's get this done.
Ow!
Are you okay?
where?
Is it bleeding?
A little.
I'll find you a bandage. Let's have a look at that finger. Ow.
It hurt.
Let's see if we can do something about it. Let's get this cut covered up.
Yes, please. Lee?
Yeah?
What if my parents come home and I'm not there?
They'll, track us down. Don't worry.
Yeah, okay. But we should keep a lookout. I've got my walkie-talkie in case they try that way.
Stay close to me until then, okay?
Find anything?
Just a picture of whoever was here.
I know who you are. You're Lee Everett. You're a professor at Athens who killed a state senator who was sleeping with your wife. This is your parents' store. Folks around town know the owner's son got himself a life sentence, but I'm a reporter for WABE in Atlanta. I paid attention to that trial. Maybe you're a murderer, but I don't really care. Frankly, that's a skill that might come in handy. Did you tell anyone out there who you were, or that you were tied to this place?
No. I've been sticking to first names for a reason.
You seem like an okay guy, and the last thing we need is drama out there. You've got this little girl to take care of, and... Look, don't make me wrong on this.
I don't plan to.
Good. Because if this lasts longer than a few days, and you're a detriment to the group, then we'd have a problem.
I hear you.
I'll just keep it to myself.
Thanks.
Don't worry about it.
Asking me that.
That lady said you killed someone. Was that because he was one of the things trying to eat you?
Yeah, he was.
And you had to protect yourself.
That's right.
Oh, okay.
We just need to get back to Fort Lauderdale.
We'll do our damnedest.
Hey there. This is Glenn, and I'm kinda in a jam here.
Little girl, if you're there, can you put your daddy on the phone? Or on the talkie or whatever?
This is Lee. What's up?
So, I'm down at that motor inn, and, well, I'm stuck.
Stuck?
Yeah, I saw a chance to get some supplies for the group, and a bunch of the Roman ones got the jump on me. I'm hiding over here, but they won't leave.
What's up? Glenn's trapped down at the motor inn. Hey, Glenn, we're gonna talk it over and send a group to come get you, alright?
Awesome. I'll sit tight till then.
Sounds good. I'm gonna hold on to this until we get Glenn back, okay? I'll take good care of it.
What do you think?
I think Doug's not great around zombies. You got your family here. I'll take Carly and her dead eye down to the motor inn, get Glenn, and get back here as fast as I can.
If that's what you want to do.
Somebody's got to.
Yeah, I'm in.
Good. Doesn't sound too bad there right now.
Let me know as soon as you want to head out. I could use a jog.
This battery should fit the radio.
Great, thanks.
You're a pretty good shot.
Well, you don't fuck with a reporter, especially one that's 3 days out from her last cup of coffee.
You ready to head out?
You got it. You?
Yeah.
Let's go. Before any of these things notice us?
Not yet. There's a survivor trapped up there.
No way. We gotta go. Now.
Listen, I was out here looking for gas. And then, up there in the corner room, I heard crying coming from inside.
Who is it?
It's a girl. We talked and she got frightened. I was trying to get in and help her and she started yelling and saying I was bitten. I tried to convince her I wasn't, and that's when all these guys came out of the forest. A couple almost got me, and I ended up hiding in the ice machine.
Lucky you. Now let's go.
We can't just leave her.
Damn right we can.
You guys are suicidal. Over a girl.
I'm saving her, with or without you.
Think about if it was you.
Fine. Let's go save Glenn's damsel in distress.
So we have to kill every one of them in here. Quietly. Noise attracts these things. Now let's have a look around.
Hey man, that drew some attention. Be careful.
Mind.
What are you gonna do with that?
I don't really know. Do you have any tricks for getting into cars?
Not without tools, or making a bunch of noise, and none with pillows.
You need to find a weapon.
I'm done trying to punch out windows.
What are you gonna do with that?
I don't really know. Do you have any tricks for getting into cars?
Not without tools, or making a bunch of noise, and none with pillows.
I think I found a pretty damn good way to stop these guys quietly.
Now we just have to get it quietly.
Get out your gun.
But the noise.
Just follow my lead. Stay right behind me.
That was sick! Awesome! That could scramble a brain pretty good.
That's exactly what I was thinking.
Dude, where'd your weapon go?
Into that ice big-sized hole.
Holy shit. It's cool. Now we've got this.
Are you two done?
Two more.
That should help.
Why don't you guys lag behind just in case this goes to hell?
Okay, we'll be right behind you.
Come on.
Rad.
Hello in there. We're here to help.
Please just go away.
Let's go, guys.
In a minute. If you open up, we can take you somewhere safer. We've got a group in town.
No. Please.
She's in trouble.
No.
Miss, we're coming in.
Stop! Just stop! I'm coming out.
You're hurt.
Oh, God.
I said stay away.
We need to get you help.
It's too late for that.
Guys, she's been bitten.
What?
I told you, I said go away! I'm bit! But you wouldn't just leave.
Let's calm down. You could be fine.
I won't be fine. My boyfriend was bitten. You get sick and you die and you come back and you kill anything you can find.
You have a boyfriend?
Glenn.
I don't want that. It's not Christian. Please, just leave me. Please go.
Okay, we'll leave. Just try to take care of yourself for whatever time you have left.
You have a gun.
So?
Can I borrow it?
What do you mean, borrow?
Give it to me. I can just, you know, end this, and then there's no problem.
Whoa.
Please, I don't want to be one of them. They're satanic.
Give it to her.
What? You can't be serious.
Do it.
No!
Look at her, Carly. There's no happy ending to this.
Okay. Fine.
Thank you so much. I know how terrible this must be.
We can't watch this. Let's go.
We can't go yet.
What? Why not?
Because somebody needs to pick up the gun. Can't leave it. You two go on.
Okay.
You sure?
Yeah. I'm here with you.
You're a good man.
Everyone all right?
Yeah, we had some close calls, but Glenn is fine and, well, yeah, we're okay.
I've got a few cans of gas for your pickup in the trunk of my car.
Good to hear it.
And things back here?
Quiet. Our friend is still in and out over there. He won't survive any more stress.
The next order of business is getting those pills out of the pharmacy. And here's another one.
Should be able to get it to work now.
It's still not working?
Yeah, I can't figure it out.
Let me have a look at that thing.
Go ahead.
Thank you.
fixed it.
Continues to spread unchecked. The estimated death toll continues to skyrocket. WABE urges you to stay indoors and avoid any contact with individuals you suspect may have been exposed.
The station is okay.
In the event of a full...
Heard or seen anything?
Nothing,
my
luckily.
Producer's telling me we have to get
step
off
outside,
here.
Have a look
Steve.
Around.
We're not suicidal yet.
No, the gate out there is closed. We can hang out in front of the store and be fine.
God bless you all.
Sure. Let's go have a look around.
Cool. And we'll keep it down. Don't need to bring them back this way with any unnecessary noises.
Agreed.
Eat. As far as I can tell, that's all they care about.
And if one gets you...
They eat you. And whatever's left comes back as one of them.
How the fuck?
I think it might be more than a couple days before all this gets sorted out.
Yeah, I think so too. We better keep it down out of here. Did you guys try to get in there and get weapons?
I did, but it was too risky. And then a bunch of guys showed up and they tried.
And what happened?
I think they're most of who you see wandering around out there.
I can't reach that brick. That place is full of TVs and electronics. Any idea where the pharmacy keys might be?
We searched high and low inside before you guys got here. They weren't on the old couple we took out of the office. Are you okay?
I'm fine. If the keys aren't in the drugstore, think they could be out here?
We now live in a world where getting up and walking away is an actual possibility, so...
Right. That guy over there has the keys.
How can you be sure?
I found this in the office. That boy in the photo worked here. The keys being on him is as good a bet as we can make.
Yeah, I agree. Just need to figure out how to get out there and get them. You wouldn't need long, right?
Nah, just a few seconds.
Maybe there's a way to distract them and buy you some time.
Think you can do anything with this?
You know what I could do?
What's that?
It's universal. I could program it to work with those TVs across the street. Let's just hope the power is still on.
You can just do that?
Well, I memorized all the codes when I was in AV. Let's try.
Well fucking done, Doug. All that dork nonsense might save a life.
Who's to say it already hasn't? That got a few of them to take notice.
But not enough.
Awesome. Now to distract those things. Carefully.
I can't reach that brick.
Thank you.
Now's the time.
Be careful.
Keep an eye out, will you? Give me a second! I'm sorry, man. I'm sorry I wasn't here. But knowing you were to take care of it, that helped. There we go.
Holy crap! Run!
Man, that was close.
But we did it. It's all that matters. I've got the keys.
Great! God, you're amazing. Let's get in there. Gotta hurry. Time to go.
I'm gonna get the truck pulled up round back!
Do it fast! I gotta get my dad out of here!
I don't plan on dilly-dallying! Honey, take Duck into the office and barricade the living hell out of the door behind me! Glenn, when you hear me honking in the alley, start getting people out of here!
You got it.
Doug, Carly, and Lee, you guys make sure our defenses stay up till then! And Lee, I better take that axe in case I run into any of them on the way to my truck!
Here you go!
Guys, that door's not locked anymore!
Shit! You three, get on it! I'll get back as fast as I can!
Stay away from the windows.
Hey, Lee. If we don't make it through this, you should know that I think you're a great guy.
Gee, thanks, Doug.
Doug, if we don't make it through this, you should know.
I should know what?
Huh?
You said I should know.
Shit!
Are you sure?
Shit!
What? Oh, shit! Okay, then. Clementine, can you look for something to stick in between the... Something real strong, okay?
Okay.
somebody else get eaten today. Even if he is an asshole.
Hey, Glenn.
Uncountable severe emergencies in all counties. Georgia's cities and their current level of disaster are as follows. Atlanta, stage 9 catastrophe. Augusta, stage 8.
I think I need to go.
Columbus,
to Atlanta?
Yeah. I got friends there. And I just can't stay here knowing that they could be trapped in that city.
Sounds like nobody knows what's happening there. When we left a few days ago, could have gone either way.
I gotta take my chances.
Find your friends. Be safe.
Thanks, Lee. That means a lot. I don't mean to abandon you all, but this seems like an okay setup, and I'm sure things will be back to normal around here in no time.
Let's hope.
You guys be safe.
We'll try.
And Lee, you know, if this doesn't get better, people are going to give up. If the girl from upstairs. Are you just gonna let them? You told Carly to give her the gun.
Yeah, I did.
Maybe you were right. I don't know how to handle something like that. Anyway, see you around.
Hey, kid.
Close call back there.
Thanks for picking me up.
No problem. We have to take care of each other.
Yeah, we do.
Earlier, I mentioned you gotta ask yourself what you're gonna do if Clementine's parents don't show.
Yeah, you did.
You think that's gonna happen?
Her parents showing up? No, I don't.
Well, I want you to know that I think you've got it in you. I think you can take care of that little girl just fine.
Thanks, Kitty.
You got it.
How you doing, Doug? Doug?
We couldn't save her, could we?
I don't think so. It happened pretty fast.
I know it's stupid. We just met. It's dumb. But, it's probably just that survivor thing. But I really liked her.
She liked you, too.
Thanks, Lee. Anyway, I'd rather be alone, I think.
I understand.
Wait, Lee?
What is it, buddy?
How did you choose? I mean, we both needed you. You picked me.
I was going to help you both.
That makes sense, I guess. But you helped me first.
Yeah, I did.
I just wish you would have picked her.
I thought Super Dinosaur was toast. But you know what? He wasn't. Oh, and then...
Hey, Duck, You want to cool it for a minute?
Okay, sorry.
I'm sorry, there's not a lot of kids here.
No, it's not that. It's... I got grabbed again.
I was there, though.
I fell, and my walkie-talkie broke. Glenn had the other one.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Thanks. I know I need to be tough. I'm just sad. I know it doesn't make any sense, but it's how I used to talk to my mom and dad. And now they're gone. It's gone.
Maybe we can find you another one.
I'll just keep this one, I guess.
Lee, come here for a second.
Let me go deal with this.
Oh, man, Clementine, another thing.
What do you want?
You like my daughter?
Her dad tried to kill me, so...
Well, he did that because he knows that Lee Everett is a convicted murderer. And so will everyone else if you go near her. You hear me? I know who you are. And I don't give a shit about what happens to you. But if anything happens to my daughter or that little girl you've got with you, you watch your ass.
Did you check the glove box?
Hey, Lee, do you have a second? My dad would be dead if it weren't for you.
That reporter is dead because of me.
You can't be like that. You're only one man.
I don't know.
We're lucky to have you.
I hope that's the sound of us winning this thing.
Me too.
This motor inn's pretty damn defendable. We block off the entrances with some cars, keep someone on watch. We could stay here until the military rolls through.
I actually agree with that plan.
Me too. We got beds, we got water, and most importantly, we got light. They're worse places to call home.
Yeah, you're right. You know, guys, I think it's going to be okay.
I thought we'd be fine if we survived the walkers. Never expected they'd starve us out.
You look like crap, Lee. When was the last time you ate?
Keep it.
Hey, I owe you a lot more than a half-eaten candy bar.
How you doing, Clementine?
I'm really hungry, Lee.
We gotta get food, Lee. Soon.
Howdy, I'm Andrew St. John. We're from the St. John Dairy.
It's beautiful.
Don't repeat what happened with the walkers at Herschel's farm. You choose the kids this time.
Something's coming, Lee. There's gonna be a war.
The walkers don't worry me as much as the bandits.
You fucked with us! Now we're gonna take what we want!
There's too many of them!
You all thought Duck was big? Well, I'm just doing the same thing. We know this guy's not gonna make it.
This isn't happening!
No more, please! No more, please!